Protect your DNA. BioPQQ can promote formation of new mitochondria. Infowarsstore.com.
Now, a long-delayed Senate report was released today. This was by the Senate Intelligence Committee, and it basically details the enhanced interrogation tactics that were put in place by the CIA. And it reveals that not only did the CIA routinely lie about the information that it received from detaining and interrogating terror suspects, but it also reveals some of the grisliest techniques that were used, methods that were far more brutal than previously acknowledged by the CIA. Now, as Feinstein released her redacted report on CIA torture, those on the left who said they initially wanted Bush, Cheney, and Rumsfeld and their minions to be held accountable have now thrown in the towel for that request, and you won't believe why.
As Gruber goes before Congress to be drilled for torturing the data about Obamacare in order to deceive the American people, a heavily edited and censored report about actual torture was released by the Senate. Republican and Democrat reactions have been as predictable as they are hypocritical. But the most surprising reaction has come from some libertarians who have in the past opposed torture. More on that in a moment, but first, the politicians. Senator Feinstein is sanctimoniously promoting the release as a confrontation of the ugly truth.
History will judge us by our commitment to a just society governed by law and the willingness to face an ugly truth and say never again.
Without any sense of irony or guilt, Feinstein says that on the very same day that the NDAA heads to the Senate floor for the fourth time under her leadership. It destroys our commitment to a just society governed by the rule of law when it presumes to authorize illegal, unconstitutional actions like indefinite detention of U.S. citizens by the military without any charges, as well as rendition and presumably enhanced interrogation, federal government's euphemism for torture. She won't face that ugly truth. She won't say never again, but rather let's do it again. And of course, after the 1,600-page NDAA was released at 10:30 at night, the GOP House passed it just a day and a half later, mocking their pledge of 2010 to always read the bill. And they're going to do the same thing with the omnibus continuing resolution spending bill, keeping it secret until just a few hours before the vote. And will the Republican who's likely to take Feinstein's place on the Senate Intelligence Committee be any better than Feinstein? Absolutely not. Richard Burr will be much worse, having already gone on record saying there shouldn't be any public hearing about what the CIA or the NSA does about anything. But the most amazing reaction that shows how low America has already sunk into accepting a lawless government comes from the executive director of the ACLU, who previously lobbied Bush to oppose presidential pardons for those who had planned and authorized torture. The ACLU director points out that neither Obama nor the Justice Department has shown any appetite for holding anyone accountable. When the department did conduct an investigation, it appeared not to have interviewed any of the prisoners who were tortured. And it repeatedly abused the state secrets privilege in order to derail cases brought by prisoners, including Americans, who were tortured as enemy combatants. But now the ACLU is calling for formal pardons for these people. Their tortured logic, worthy of John Gruber, is that doing nothing, as Obama has and will do, is a tacit pardon. We need to have, they say, an explicit pardon, so we can, as a society, at least acknowledge that laws were broken. That's it. No longer any hope of criminal prosecution for leaders and government employees who violate the law, commit treason, and torture people, including American citizens. No, the best we can hope for is to say it was wrong. But don't think that you're going to even get that in this kind of lawless society. Our government no longer has the will to punish cops who murder or politicians who torture and murder. That's the real ugly truth we have to confront. For InfoWars Nightly News, I'm David Knight.
Introducing the first proprietary oxygen-based intestinal cleanser, OxyPowder. Backed by FDA-approved phase 1, 2, and 3 clinical trials. All the toxins from the air, the food, the water, ultimately ends up in the gut or affects the gut. Take your health into your own hands and start cleansing your body today with OxyPowder. Secure your OxyPowder today at InfowarsLife.com. That's InfowarsLife.com.
Thank you.